Fecal Matter emerged onto the grunge scene in early 1985, a brainchild of Kurt Cobain, fresh from dropping out of Aberdeen High School. Part of a trend of joke bands within the circle of friends surrounding influential grunge pioneers, the Melvins. Fecal Matter initially comprised Kurt Cobain on vocals and guitar, Dale Crover of the Melvins on bass, and their friend Greg Hokeson on drums. Their material was a mix of original compositions and covers, spanning genres from punk to classic rock, with influences ranging from the Ramones to Led Zeppelin and Jimi Hendrix. In the modest surroundings of Cobain's aunt's house in Setauk, Washington, the duo of Cobain and Crover embarked on recording their demo, Illiteracy Will Prevail. Utilizing a basic four-track recorder, the precise date of this recording session has been a subject of debate amongst music historians, with conflicting accounts suggesting either December 1985 or late March 1986. Accompanied solely by Dale Crover, Cobain laid down vocals and guitar for the tracks, capturing a raw and abrasive punk sound reflective of his electric musical taste, blending the influences of Black Sabbath and Black Flag. Kurt Cobain sings and plays the guitar on the album, and it's believed that he wrote all of the lyrics. Dale Crover plays both bass and drums. Kurt Cobain's aunt witnessed the process and recalls being struck by the content of the lyrics. After recording several songs, everything was transferred onto a cassette. It was the first tangible proof of Kurt Cobain's musical talent. By 1986, Fecal Matter underwent lineup changes, with Buzz Osborne and former Melvins drummer Mike Dillard joining on bass and drums. However, this incarnation proved short-lived, marred by tensions over commitment and dedication to the band's musical aspirations. The group's sole live performance under this lineup occurred on May 3, 1986, in Olympia, under the name Brown Towel, which was misspelled to read Brown Cow. Ultimately, Fecal Matter disbanded later in 1986, amidst the burgeoning success of the Melvins and their debut EP, Six Songs. Despite Fecal Matter's disillusion, Kurt Cobain remained committed to sharing their demo tape with friends and acquaintances. Among those who received a copy was Chris Novoselic, a fellow musician who Cobain had long admired and whom he had briefly jammed in the past. Novoselic was taken by the song Spank Through. Recognizing the potential for collaboration, Cobain and Novoselic agreed to form a new band together. In late 1986, rehearsals commenced for the fledgling project. Drawing inspiration from the material Cobain had previously recorded with Fecal Matter, songs like Downer and the aforementioned Spank Through were revisited and reimagined for the band's setlist. While Spank Through would later find official release on Nirvana's 2005 Rarities album, Sliver, The Best of the Box, its themes of adolescent angst and frustration were emblematic of Cobain's signature style. The song blends satire with raw energy, offering commentary on the trials and tribulations of youth. Downer, another track from the Fecal Matter demo, was re-recorded for Nirvana's debut album Bleach, although it ultimately did not make the final cut. Despite the band's subsequent rise to fame, the Illiteracy Will Prevail demo remained a coveted item for collectors, fueling a brisk trade in bootleg copies. However, in March 2006, an incomplete and low-quality version of the demo surfaced online, sparking renewed interest among fans. The only well-documented copy of the album is retained by Cobain's widow, Courtney Love. However, in early August of 2015, an unknown source leaked the full demo tape to the internet. This attracted the attention of numerous music publications, who commented on the importance of the demo in understanding the mind and life of Cobain. Rumors circulated that Dave Grohl was the one responsible for the leak, but this has never been proven. The original YouTube upload of the leak was taken down due to a copyright claim, but has been frequently mirrored by other fans, marking an end to the search. All right, thanks for watching. So what do you think of the demo, Illiteracy Will Prevail? It's not necessarily a masterpiece, but I don't think Kurt designed it to be that. But it's still a cool part of Nirvana's history. I think it's interesting that the song Spank Through lasted so long in Nirvana's set list. I remember first hearing it on the live album from the Muddy Banks of Wishka, and at the time I thought that it was just a cover or something, but still a good song. Illiteracy Will Prevail might be seen as just a low quality demo of Kurt Cobain's, but I think it's more than that. It's part of their history of that initial spark that ignited Nirvana. Anyways, thanks for watching. I'm trying to grow this channel, do more videos on the subject of Kurt Cobain and Nirvana and their material throughout the years. If you haven't already, consider subscribing. And again, thanks for watching.